tour of the portal. Dashboard. The dashboard is the window that opens upon login. The dashboard consists of an auto-collapsing left navigation bar, or nav bar, a carousel containing widgets that provide different views of the data collected by Sky ATP, and the main viewing area in which widgets can be positioned. The dashboard can be customized to your preferences by dragging widgets from the carousel to the main viewing area. Each of the widgets have a top bar that turns gray as you roll your mouse over it. The top bar can be used to reposition the widget elsewhere on the page, rename the widget, refresh the widget's data, and delete the widget from the main viewing area. Additionally, there are pull-down menus that allow you to change what data is shown and adjust the time period for the displayed data. Multiple tabs can be set up within the main viewing area that allow you to maintain custom views. Monitor pages. The monitor pages are used to display compromised hosts in your network, command and control servers used by malware, file scanning results, blocked email attachments, and telemetry information. Hosts. Use this page to view a list of compromised hosts and the threat levels associated with the compromise. Hosts information includes IP address, threat level, blocked status, when the threat was seen, command and control hits, and the malware detections. The state of the threat investigation is also tracked here. Use this page to view information on command and control or Cnc servers. A Cnc server is a centralized computer that issues commands to compromised networks of computers known as botnets and receives information back from them. Cnc servers are detected when protected hosts reach out to known Cnc IPs or URLs. Information such as IP address, threat level, and country of origin are displayed. Under the File Scanning tab, we have HTTP File Download. Use this page to view information on files downloaded by hosts and found to be suspicious based on known signatures, source URLs, and other automated scanning tools, such as known malicious file hashes, multiple parallel antivirus engines, static software payload analysis, advanced sandboxing with advanced provocation and detection techniques. The file hash, threat level, file name, date and time of last download, URL, malware name, and category are displayed. Email attachments. Use this page to view information on files downloaded via email. The analysis techniques are the same as those used for HTTP file downloads. The file hash, threat level, date scanned, file name, recipient, sender, malware name, and category are shown. Manual uploads. Use this page to view information on suspicious files that have been manually submitted for investigation. The file hash, file name, threat level, malware name, category, and other information are displayed. Blocked email tab. Use these pages to view quarantined SMTP emails and blocked IMAP emails. Both pages provide a timeline for filtering from 12 hours to 30 days. Both pages have summary and detail view tabs. The summary views give an overall picture of either SMTP or IMAP mail scans and the actions taken against malicious attachments in the messages. The detail view lists details regarding individual messages and their attachments, including threat score, sender, recipient, and action. SMTP quarantine. On the detail view of the SMTP quarantine tab, selecting messages from the list allows you to take action on quarantined emails like blacklisting the source domain or sender or releasing a selected message from quarantine. IMAP block. On the detail view of the IMAP block tab, selecting messages from the list allows you to unblock IMAP attachments for individual recipients or for all recipients. Telemetry tab. The telemetry page provides comprehensive monitoring and information of SRX devices for a variety of activities, including the number of web and email files scanned or blocked per protocol. It also offers counter reset capability. Devices page. The devices page shows a list of devices that are enrolled in your security realm. On this page, you can click on a device serial number to get details regarding that device, including device information, configuration information regarding blacklist, whitelist, and profile versions, and connection information between the device and Sky ATP. click the All Devices link to the right of the collapsible nav bar to return to the main device list. The Enroll button provides an op command that allows you to add devices to this security realm. The Disenroll button provides an op command that removes the Sky ATP certificates from your device and removes it from the Sky ATP security realm. The Remove button removes the device from the device list but does not provide the op command that removes the Sky ATP certificates and configuration from the device. The Device Lookup button is used to query the Sky ATP enrollment database to determine if a license has been provisioned for a specific device. The wizard that appears asks for a device serial number. Enter the serial number for a supported SRX series device and click Next. On the next page, the search results are displayed. Click Close to return to the main devices page. Configure page. File Inspection Management tab. Profiles. Use the File Inspection Profiles page to group types of files to be scanned together under a common name. You can create multiple profiles based on the content you want scanned and enter the profile names on eligible SRX series devices to apply them. There is a default profile included with Sky ATP. This profile cannot be altered. Click on the plus sign to create a new profile. In the window that appears, different file types are available. Select a scanning option for each file type. You can do hash-only scans, which are faster but less secure, no scan, or a full scan of each file type. For full scans, enter a value limit for the file size in megabytes up to a maximum of 32 megabytes. Files above the set limit are not sent to the cloud for scanning. Hash-only scans are not recommended because they only compare with files that have been scanned before. Blacklists and whitelists. The Configure page allows you to create custom whitelists and blacklists by URL or IP. IP addresses and URLs listed on whitelists are trusted. Sky ATP does not inspect the traffic for malware. IP addresses and URLs listed on blacklists are considered untrusted. Internal hosts cannot access content from IPs or URLs that appear on a blacklist. You can also add hash files to either blacklists or whitelists. These SHA-256 hash items are the results of uploading content to Sky ATP for inspection. Email management. SMTP. Use this page to configure email management for SMTP. With email management for SMTP, enrolled SRX devices transparently submit suspicious emails to Sky ATP for inspection and quarantining. You can customize the message that is sent to the intended recipient of quarantined email. You can also provide a custom URL to allow the recipient to preview the quarantined email in Sky ATP and take action on them. You can also send notification of quarantined and released emails to administrators if so desired. IMAP. Use this page to configure email management for IMAP. Email management for IMAP, enrolled SRX devices transparently submit suspicious emails to Sky ATP for inspection and blocking. For IMAP, you can set the same things as for SMTP email with the addition of allowing an administrator to unblock suspect emails. Use the whitelist page to configure custom email whitelists using sender email addresses. If a sender's email address matches the whitelist, that email is allowed through without any scanning. Use the blacklist page to configure custom email blacklists. The sender's email address is checked against this list. If a sender's email address matches the blacklist, it is considered to be malicious and is handled the same way as an email with a malicious attachment. Third-party feeds. Use the third-party feeds page to enable external threat feeds for use with Sky ATP. Security policies will block malicious IP addresses and domains based on enabled third-party feeds, but these events do not affect host threat scores. Global configuration. Use this page to set a global alert threshold level, which when reached triggers an alert to all listed email addresses. You can enable logging for malware and host status by checking the boxes. Email addresses can be added by clicking the plus sign and filling out the form. You can have multiple addresses per threat level. Threat intelligence sharing. Use the threat intelligence sharing page to enable the TAXI, Trusted Automated Exchange of Indicator Information service for STICS, or Structured Threat Information Expression Reports. STICS is a language used for reporting and sharing threat information using TAXI. Sky ATP can contribute to STICS reports by sharing the threat intelligence it gathers from file scanning. You can choose who you share threat information with by creating an application token from the administration menu. Proxy servers. Use this page to add the IP addresses of trusted proxy servers to a list. Having a list of trusted proxy servers helps Sky ATP determine the originating address of an HTTP or HTTPS request routed through a proxy server on this list. Administration page. My profile. Use the My Profile page to view and change information regarding the currently logged in user. Users. Use the Users page to add, delete, and modify users for this Sky ATP security realm. Clicking the plus sign brings up a window in which you set the first and last name, email address, and password of the user. The email address is used as the login for this Sky ATP realm. Application tokens. Application tokens authorize other applications to Sky ATP's APIs over HTTPS. For security director or open APIs to securely access Sky ATP APIs, they must have the correct application token. With the Sky ATP web UI, you can generate and manage application tokens. To create an application token, click the plus sign, name the token, and give it a description if desired. Once generated, you must copy and paste the application token before closing the screen. Once you close the generation screen, the token is no longer available for copying. Paste the generated token into the security director and third-party feed's initial configuration process. You can activate and deactivate the tokens in the list by clicking the checkbox next to the token name and using the appropriate buttons. Deactivated tokens block access from security director and third-party feeds. You can delete a token by selecting its checkbox and clicking the X. Deleted tokens cannot be recovered.